So we've got a new type of orc in the Beast Snaggas. So maybe people will be familiar with the kind of idea of the different kind of subcultures within orky society. Orcs kind of get really easily obsessed with one thing. So people might know about the speed freaks, where orcs just get really obsessed with going really, really fast. The Beast Snaggas are orcs that kind of become obsessed with hunting, fighting the biggest monsters that they can find. And they tend to fight like orcs then tend to kind of form like with like. So they tend to band together in groups who have like the same kind of obsessions. And so the Beast Snaggas are orcs that hunt kind of vehicles, monsters. They travel the galaxy looking for the biggest, toughest things that they can fight. And so they have like a really nomadic kind of feel to them. They're hunters. You'll see on the models, there's loads of kind of bits of like animal hide and teeth. They also have quite a lot of bionics. It's quite dangerous hunting monsters and also looking after squigs. So I think there's a fair number of orcs that lose their hands and feet to dangerous monsters. So they also have quite a lot of kind of technology and bionics and upgrades. Their pain boys are very busy. So with the launch of the Beast Snaggas, it is a new kind of subculture of orcs. It works across all of the different clans. So I've added some to my Goth army. And in the box, you get several units of the new Beast Snagger boys. You also get the Squig Hog boys. So Beast Snagger boys riding on these kind of much bigger squigs than things that we've seen before. Quite often with a little grot kind of sidekick hanging on the back. And also the return of a character that we've not seen for a very long time in Warhammer, all the way back from the distant past of Rogue Trader and second edition of Zograd Wartsnagger, who's a kind of rogue runt herd. So the legend tells that he kind of became obsessed with building breeding the smartest and cleverest of grots and runts, which was something that most other orcs thought was a giant waste of time. And at one point he ends up firing a mech boy through his own shock attack gun, because he feels like he's been like wasting the super grots. He gets exiled from his clan and kind of becomes a rogue runt herd. So like a really cool character that we haven't seen in decades really, returning to the fold. So you can use the Beast Snaggas in any orc army. You could collect a whole army of Beast Snaggas if you like, or you can add them to any other orc army. I've added them to my Goths. I've got a big Goth army, and I've added a selection of Beast Snaggas in, all painted up as Goths. In the same way as Speed Freaks can be from any clan, but tend to have kind of, there's a lot of them in the Evil Sons, kind of the things that those clans like and their subcultures align quite neatly. The same with the Beast Snaggas. So any orc army can take them, they can be from any clan. There's quite a lot of them in the Snakebite clan. Their kind of philosophies, if that's the right word to use for orcs, kind of align very neatly. So they're very predominant amongst Snakebites, but yes, you can use them in any clan. They tend to be a bit bigger and stronger than your average orc boy and quite fast. They have a lot of kind of supporting things that enable them to move around the battlefield quite quickly. They do feel kind of like hunting packs that kind of head out across the battlefield and hunt down kind of the enemy's key units. So the Beast Snaggas launch is really exciting, whether you're an orc fan like me who's been collecting orcs for years and years, or somebody brand new. I think if you're brand new to orcs, it's a great opportunity to start a new type of orc army that's never been seen before. With the Beast Snaggas, you could really kind of just lean into that theme and just collect that. It would be a great starting point. And if you're an experienced orc war boss and you've got loads of orcs already, this will give you a whole load of new orc things to explore and really kind of give you a different way of maybe playing with the existing miniatures that you have and the way that they kind of synergize and work together. So I'm a big fan of the orcs. If you have an orc army, I'm lucky enough that mine appears in the book in the Crusade section, which was a real privilege. And I think my favorite thing about the Beast Snaggas is that they really feel like a kind of building on a really strong archetype of orcs that we've maybe not really played with before, all the way back again, feels like hundreds of years ago in the original kind of orc, War the Orc type books, there was this idea of squigs and how orcs kind of have their own ecosystem. And this is a really great opportunity to explore that and really kind of go deep into some kind of orc background that's been around for a really long time, but maybe we haven't really been able to explore before. So one of the things in the launch box is the new codex, which isn't just about Beast Snaggas, it's about the whole orc range. We really wanted to take a good look at how orcs play on the battlefield. They actually perform really well at the moment in the game. There's big blocks of orc boys are really potent on the battlefield, which is great. But we also wanted to make sure that the other play styles that book can build are equally kind of valid as a way of playing the game and equally fun. So we really looked at things like Speed Freaks and those kind of things to make sure that the full codex really felt like however you wanted to play with your orc army, you could make an army list out of that book that really enabled you to do that on the battlefield. So whether that is Speed Freak type themed army with loads of buggies and trucks and bikes, or you really did want to lean into the Beast Snaggers and have loads of squigs and those kind of things, or you know, a traditional goth or infantry horde. You had loads of different ways of playing with orcs, all of which gave you a great experience on the battlefield and interesting things to do with them. So that was kind of our main focus, as well as then taking a good look at every data sheet in the book, tweaking them, toning them, updating them, just to make them as good as they possibly could be in the game.